Making your way in the world today takes everything you got. Taking a break from all your worries sure could help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away?
Singapore.
Oh, wow. Let me tell him.
All right, go ahead.
Miss Amber, editor of our college newspaper and literary magazine, has been named the new managing editor of Asian Living Today. Never heard of it.
I know. Nobody has. But that will soon change.
Okay.
Well, as much as I love this stimulating conversation, guys, I've got to catch my train back to the city.
You will be back in time for the UNO.
Absolutely. I wouldn't miss it.
Bye. Man, it was good seeing her again, huh? We had some good times, didn't we? We were gonna rule the world. Who are you calling?
Kathy.
You know the girl I told you about.
The one I'm moving in with?
You know the one. I want to let her know you're back in town so you two can. Do not let her know that I'm back yet.
Why not?
Because you said that her mom and my mom run the same hospital committee. Well, Catherine will tell her mom, who will tell my mom, who will then tell my dad, who will then tell my granddad, and I do not want him to know that I'm back yet.
Why wouldn't you want your family to know you're back in town?
He's always trying to set me up with some girl.
Who? I didn't realize your grandfather was such a matchmaker.
He's got this wild idea that I'll meet this girl, fall madly in love, get married, and live happily ever after.
What's wrong with happily ever after?
Josh, I've lived in Berlin. I've studied music in Prague. I want to live in the hustle and bustle of a city. I don't want to be stuck in this nowhere town again.
Excuse you?
Well, you know what I mean. Everyone that we ever went to high school with still lives here. Even the ones who got out for a little bit, Snoop came back here. But look at you.
What about me?
You went to the conservatory. But you could have gotten that fellowship to Munich, but instead you came back here to teach sixth graders how to read music.
Now, you know there was a very good reason.
I know. A dad got sick and you had to take care of him, but I'd feel trapped if I had to come back here again. I mean, here everyone else knows everyone else's name. I want to be where nobody knows my name. I don't want to settle down yet. I want to date lots of different women and not have to worry if this one's going to run into that one.
Afraid they'll compare notes?
Oh, man. It's just that I want to make something of my life. I want to feel alive. I want to live in a tiny studio apartment above a after-hours jazz club that smells like Chinese takeout and old socks, you know? If I came back here, my parents, my granddad would start in all over again on me about getting a real job and then make me keep a promise that my granddad made to a dead friend.
Well, this is about the girl, right? The one your grandfather's so hot for you to date? Who is she?
I don't know. She's the granddaughter of some guy that saved his life in the Marines during some war to Korea, I think. Anyway, they lost touch until they hired a PI a few years ago to find them. They've been writing back and forth ever since, until a few months ago when they got together in Vegas and decided that their respective grandchildren would be perfect for each other.
So just go out with her. It's not like you have to marry her. Don't tell me there's strings attached.
My trust fund? dear a beloved granddad changed the terms last month. You know the money that we were going to use to open our own shop? Yeah, I don't get it unless I marry her. I don't even know this chick and I have to marry her or I can kiss all my plans of goodbye. Not to mention yours.
Wow. Well, can't we just raise the capital somewhere else?
It's $3.5 million interest free. Where else are we going to get that kind of investment making lutes and stringed instruments without having to pay through the nose for it? That is if we could get a loan in this credit market.
Is she even cute?
I don't know. All I've got is this old picture that Granddad gave me. Look at that.
You have got to be kidding me. She's, what, 12 in this picture? Braces and all.
Yeah.
What good is this?
I hate to think of the picture Granddad sent her of me.
Oh, probably the one where you had the mohawk with the ends of the spikes and the eyebrows dyed electric blue.
Probably.
So when do you get to meet Princess Brace Face?
Tomorrow. Granddad set up a meet and greet at his lawyer's office after hours. We have to go there and sign some papers or something stupid like that.
What am I going to do? Look, I'll call Catherine. She's got a college friend staying with us this week. Smoking hot. We'll go out for drinks and dancing. You'll have a great time. You can forget about your grandfather's matchmaking.
I'm not going to have fun, Josh.
You never know. You might really like Catherine's friend.
And what good would that do me? I've got my whole future planned out for me, don't I?
One drink.
Fine. But I'm not going to sleep with her.
Now, where do you have to go tomorrow?
To meet the grandson of my grandfather's new best friend. This guy he wants me to marry.
Excuse me, did you just say marry? Have you ever seen this guy before?
Maybe 15 or 20 years ago, he might have come by with his father.
Why is your grandfather set on marrying this guy?
Well, you know how old school my family is. This guy is the grandson of the man who saved my grandfather's life in a rice field in Vietnam or somewhere when they were in the Marines. He said it a million times. If it weren't for Jake Truman, you wouldn't be here, little lady. I swear if I wanted to hear that one more time, I think I would have slit my wrists.
I may get some cookies and a thank you for my life note. You don't have to marry his grandson.
Actually, I do. You know the publishing company my family owns? The one I got my MBA for? The one I've been running for the past 4 years? Well, Grandfather decided I don't get to inherit the family business until I get engaged to Jake Truman's grandson.
And your dad is okay with this?
I can't do anything about it. It's all in the terms of Grandfather's will. If I don't marry this guy, the executor of Grandfather's estate sells the company and gives the money to the Flat Earth Society.
Who is the Flat Earth Society?
This group Grandfather knew I would hate. You're trying to prove that the Earth is the center of the universe.
Oh, I can't believe this. I thought marriage is about love and commitment and companionship and all that eHarmony drivel.
Yes, well, perhaps for you mere peasants it is, but for those of us in the merchant classes it is not.
Seriously, Julia, what are you going to do?
I'm going to at least meet him. I mean, it's not like I've had the greatest luck with men before. Remember Roger?
Roger, the transcendental nudist? Yeah, who could ever forget him? I mean, he shows up to the charity ball wearing nothing but a black silk tie and a mask. Literally, nothing else.
Oh, what about Mitch? I swear, if any guy ever again mentions World of Warcraft, that's it. Instant die.
Oh, and don't forget Bobby.
Oh, if you're going to mention Bobby, I'm going to bring up Claude.
Oh, God, not Claude. Anyone but Claude. Well, Uncle, you win.
Thank you. Anyway, there are some problems with the terms of Grandfather's will.
Like what?
Well, I talked to the lawyers, and the terms are very specific. Apparently, he's under some similar restriction. If he breaks off the engagement, I get my company and his trust fund. But if I break it off, he gets his money and my company.
Ooh, what happens if you both break it off?
Oh, then neither of us gets anything.
How long do you have to stay married?
Yeah, it's another really specific term of this whole stupid agreement. 15 years? Yeah. Yeah, if either of us strays or we separate before we've been married 15 years, everything goes back to the estate and we have to repay the trust fund.
Do you even know what this guy looks like?
Not really. All I have is an old picture his grandfather sent me. Oh, there, my future husband.
Oh, my sweet Nana, how old is this picture? He's got a mohawk. Are his eyebrows blue?
Does he have more than one? Look at it, all I see is the blonde brow.
Julia, I can't believe you're considering this for a minute.
Catherine, this company has been in my my family for six generations now. I promised my grandmother I would do whatever it takes to keep it in the family. Besides, how bad can he be? He's been in Europe on a Fulbright for the past 2 years, and you don't get a Fulbright if you're stupid.
Yeah, and he's okay with this, too.
I don't know. I haven't even talked to him.
Hold on just a second. Oh, it's Josh. Do you want to
go ahead?
Hey, babe. What's up? Really? And he's cute? Oh, of course she would love to go. Okay, we'll see you at 7. Smoochies!
Do not tell me you just set me up on a blind date.
Come on, Julia. Just one date. Josh says he's really cute and you don't have to marry this one. Just drinks, dinner, dancing, conversation, and after that, who knows?
I'm not gonna sleep with him.
Oh, nobody said you had to. Although, you never know.
Oh, Catherine.
I was just thinking how beautiful you are in the morning sunlight and how breakfast in bed might have been the better choice.
Breakfast in bed with you sounds like the perfect way to end a great night.
You were wonderful.
Well, you were pretty fantastic yourself. I could just lose myself in your eyes. I'm not being corny either. I mean it. I could love you. I could see myself falling so hard for you. You're everything a woman could possibly want.
And you're all that I could see myself with forever. I've never met anyone like you before. I feel like I could tell you everything. I feel like I could tell you all my hopes, my fears, my dreams. I just want to know everything about you.
Jeffrey, I really find you to be the most interesting man I've ever met in my life. I mean, we just met, what, 12 hours ago? And already I can see everything. The house, the beautiful babies we could have together, but
what? It's too fast. It's too much. I know. I feel scared too. But sometimes we just have to go for what we want. I never believed in love at first sight, but then I
saw you.
Yeah.
Isn't it crazy how we can go our whole lives wanting something, and then when we're not looking for it, that's when it happens.
Christine, will you marry me?
Yes.
You did what?
Man, it was incredible and so romantic. She's the most amazing person I've ever met. I was literally and psychologically naked in front of her, and yet completely at ease. I could tell her anything. I asked her to marry me.
Whoa, wait a minute. You asked her to marry you?
Yeah.
I thought you just slept with her.
No, man.
Oh, Princess Bracefit. You didn't even tell her your real name.
Somebody made up a name. What's the big deal?
The big deal is that you're Miss Wonderful, Miss Right, the most amazing woman in the world doesn't know who you are. She doesn't even know what to call you.
Well,
and you go and fall in love the day before you're supposed to meet the girl that your grandfather insists you marry. Or did you just conveniently forget about that little detail?
No, I haven't forgotten that detail. It's just that now I have to figure out a way to get Princess Braceface to break off the engagement.
Well, what difference would that make? You're still lying to Catherine's friend.
It'd make all the difference in the world.
Why?
Because according to the terms of the trust fund, if she breaks it off, I get everything. The money and her family's company.
What company?
Some publishing company. No, but that doesn't matter.
What would you want with a publishing company?
Nothing. You're losing focus. I don't even want her family's company. I'd probably give it back to her, no strings attached. That's not the point.
So what is?
The point is that I've got to get her to dump me so that I can be with Christine. You've got to help me.
Are you serious? You just met this woman last night. You had two rum and cokes. Catherine and I go out to the dance floor. We come back and find out there's a message for you. You both had emergencies and had to leave.
Well,
you then don't answer when I try to bring you. Then I find out that you lied to this woman. You asked me to marry you using a fake name, and now you want me to help you.
I don't think so. Come on, Josh. Haven't you ever wanted something so badly that it physically hurts?
Who's ever wanted something like that? I see the way you look at Catherine and the way that she looks at you. Well, I want that too, and I found it last night in Christine. It's, oh man, it's true love.
Really?
Yeah.
True love, really. Well, what about Andrea? That's true love. Oh, and Brenda. You said that was Brenda true love. And what about April? Wasn't that true love too?
Look, I know what you must be thinking.
Oh, no, you have no idea.
Look, you know, I know you better than you know yourself, and you know my past, but this is different. I told her about my loots.
You told her about the loot shots?
Yeah.
Wow, I guess this must really be love, then. You never told anybody except me. Is she really that important?
Yes. She completes me. I can't breathe when she's not around. She's the other part of me that's been missing my whole life.
Tell her the truth and let the money go.
How am I supposed to get by without it, huh? I make lutes and stringed instruments. You know, everyone else thinks that I was on the Fulbright, but you know I was working in the off-the-house workshop. It's not exactly a huge growth industry in fine instrument making, especially when you don't have any tools or supplies.
So you get a different job. Why do you think I teach middle school? There's not a huge market for lute players in this world, either.
I had my trust fund. You wouldn't have to teach anymore. I would make the instruments. You would play them. Catherine would write the music. Christine would produce the CDs. Our lives would be so much better. And it's not like we'd be screwing around with anything either.
All right. We've got to turn you into the most repulsive man on the planet. What is this girl like? Do we know?
Granddad said that she likes smart men who can carry on witty conversations, and she thinks blondes with mullets are too dumb.
Okay, good. So we'll change your hair color. Wig, Duncan. I know you said Christine likes your hair the way it is.
All right.
You'll have to keep your mouth shut. Turn off the brain. We might need to give you a beer gut, too, for good measure.
To the repulsive me.
To driving away unwanted brides. Cheers. Cheers.
Store in the mall after breakfast before I came here.
You said yes?
Yeah.
forgotten where you have to go this afternoon? Mohawk Man with the blue eyebrows, remember him? Family Publishing Company. Is any of this ringing a bell in here?
Yeah, I know where and who and what I have to do this afternoon. I have to figure a way out of this mess.
Do you really think that Jack's going to be waiting around for you when he finds out you've been lying to him?
Would you stop using that word? I didn't lie. I just didn't tell the truth.
Same difference.
All I have to do is find a way to make this Truman guy break off the engagement.
Well, here's an idea. It's strange, I know. But why not tell him the truth? Tell him about Jeff.
Catherine, don't be stupid. I love Jeffrey, but I'm not just going to lose my family's business. I've got to figure out a way to help both. You know, a win-win situation.
But either you marry someone you don't know and don't like, or you lose everything.
Which is why we have to come up with a plan.
We? Who is this we you're talking about?
Oh, Catherine, come on. You know somewhere inside that tough, honest shell of yours is the happily ever after gene. You are the true romantic. That's why you're so upset that I slept with Jeff. But he's different. I want him forever, not just for right now. You've got to help me find a way out of this mess.
But if you love Jeff that much, then just tell Mohawk Man and walk away.
Catherine, Jeff makes lutes and handcrafted wooden art. Think what I could do for him if I had my family's business. He'd never have to worry about money. It's not like I keep Mohawk Man's trust fund.
Well, if you love Jeff this much, does any of this really matter?
Yeah, spoken like the true romantic. Catherine, you know it does. Just because you and Josh think you can live comfortably on two teacher salaries doesn't mean anyone else can. Money does matter. Even if we really connect on this amazingly deep level, the rent still has to be paid.
Nice girls don't marry for money.
Whoever said I was a nice girl? Besides, Jeff wouldn't want me to give up on my dreams. He sees into my soul.
No, we all know that soul gazing is the basis for every great relationship. Oh, of course I'll help you. Do you know anything about this guy? Other than he used to dye his eyebrows blue?
Well, Daddy said that Grandfather said that he likes smart, witty women who can talk about art, music, politics, and religion. Oh, and blondes. Apparently he likes blondes.
That's easy enough to fix. You'll just have to be the dumbest dumbernet ever. We'll put some acne breakouts on your face. Yeah. And you'll have to stare off in the space a lot. And wear really thick glasses. Can you pretend to be stupid?
Oh, to be best friends with an acting teacher.
Mohawk Man will run the other way so fast, no one will be able to stop
you. Oh, Catherine, I love you.
Josh, I told you I could do it. Yes, yes, I stood over by the pumps. Yeah, although there were several people who just drove away when they saw me standing here, and it almost got me arrested for loitering. But yeah, yes, I offered the pump the gas for them. Yeah. Yes, I got some on my hands and clothes, and well, yes, 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 I've been chewing on raw garlic and onions for at least half an hour now. And I'm, dude, I'm not gonna do that. I don't care if it's guaranteed to work. There are some things that even I won't do for money, okay? Look, I'm not gonna fart in front of her or the lawyer. You got it? Look, look, someone's coming.
Mr. Duncan Truman? This is Mr. J.D. Denmark.
Hey, but you can call me Dunk. Like them little donuts, huh?
Yes. Well, my daughter is running a bit late. It seems she'd undoubtedly want me to keep you company while we wait for her. We have so much in common. Your grandfather says that you enjoy music. I myself have season tickets to both the symphony and the opera. Music. Good, real good. Honky tonk. Woo-hoo-hoo!
banging music, if you catch my drift. Get it?
Banging music.
Yes, I've got it. Will you excuse me, Mr. Truman? I didn't make a call. Is there a private place I can make a call?
Yes, sir. This way.
No need to be all private like. I can just shut my ears and hum.
Julian, answer the phone. Julian, this is your father. I've just met this man, this Duncan Truman. Under no circumstances are you making any overtures towards this man whatsoever. You hear me? None. The family business be damned. Call me before you get here. I really must sit down somewhere away from him.
Yes, sir. Come this way.
Excuse me. Mr. Truman, stop humming. I'm trying to speak to you.
What? Oh. I said, you didn't fart, did you? You know, sometimes those stink bombs can be real silent but deadly. Oh, yeah.
No, Mr. Truman. I have some important papers I need to sign. All right. I'll see you at a later date.
All right. Don't fart in the elevator.
Well, what?
Aren't you gonna introduce me?
To who?
Oh, don't you work here? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought someone as classy as you and such a good dresser would be the receptionist here. I'm supposed to meet my true love here tonight. Yeah. My granddaddy found him for me. I wonder what he looks like.
Your granddaddy?
Oh, no, silly. My ducky wonky.
Oh, no, this must be her. She's absolutely repulsive. I can't do this. I gotta get her to break it off.
Well, I'm a dunk. Duncan Truman.
Oh, please, no. Oh, it looks like he's never even been on a date before, much less been kissed, and his breath is about to kill me. He's never gonna break it off. What am I gonna do? Well, Donkey Wonky, I'm Julia!
So, Juju, what's your technique?
What?
No, your technique. That's what I really like. Especially when I haven't showered in a few weeks. That's when it's real good. Sometimes like it 5, 6, 7 times a day.
Oh, no. Oh, no! That's nasty! Nice girls don't do that. And I'm a nice girl.
Mr. Truman, Miss Denmar, wonderful. If you both would follow me, we can get this started.
Great.
I don't care, Harrison. Find me a way out of this contract. I will not have my daughter married to that man. What am I paying you for then? Yeah, well, then you're fired. You heard me. Dad, we've really done it this time. Oh, good Lord, here he comes again.
Hey, it's my soon-to-be daddy. So, Dad, what do you say to me and you and some male up bonding time, huh?
Oh, I don't think so. I must go see my daughter.
All right, go see her. So, babe, what do you say to you and me, the horizontal pop? Could be fun.
Seriously.
Oh, yeah. I'm always serious when I'm talking about love.
Not in a million years.
Really? You're rejecting all this? I thought only blondes were dumb.
You can leave anytime now, Mr. Truman.
You know, you can call me Dunk. All my ladies do.
Oh, you must not hear it very often, goodbye.
Wow, this is gonna be harder than I thought. Is the money really worth this? Maybe Josh was right. Maybe I should just walk away. Maybe being a starving artist isn't that bad.
Thank you.
I met him. I forbid you to even consider marrying him. He's repulsive. He's rude, crude, loud, stupid, obnoxious, and he smells! I absolutely forbid you to even consider marrying this man.
Daddy, calm down. In the first place, I'm almost 30 years old, and you can't forbid me to do anything. And secondly, I know what I'm doing. I have a plan.
You have a plan? You have a freaking plan? She has a plan, May! You hear that? She has a plan! You're just like your mother. Plans for everything, and nothing ever works.
Oh, J.D., just calm down. Now, if Julia says that she has a plan, then she has a plan. She's one smart young woman. She also gets that from her mother, God rest her soul. Besides, you shouldn't think ill of the dead.
You cannot win this one. The man has absolutely no reason not to go through with this. He would be absolutely miserable.
Don't worry, Daddy. I'm going to get everything I want. The family business and the man of my dreams.
Duncan Truman is not the man of your dreams. He's more like a walking nightmare.
Well, Julia, honey, how are you going to do that? You know you can't change a man. You have to take him as you find him, warts and all. Not that you have any warts, J.D. Honestly, Julia, you are stuck with the man that your father described in the most profoundly terrifying terms.
May, I'm smart. Grandfather was smart, but not as smart as I am. I read the terms of the will very carefully. The solution is simple, really.
Which is what? I've been through that document 5 times with 5 different Harvard-trained lawyers, forwards and backwards, and we didn't find any loopholes.
Well, there's a big one. If Duncan Truman breaks off the engagement, I get everything. The family business and his trust fund.
And how are you going to make that happen? A man would have to be blind, gay, and stupid to turn you down. I think the blind gay ones would still walk you down the aisle, a gorgeous thing like you with money attached.
I like my view. We leverage everything and buy out the Flat Earth Society. Then we can break the terms of Father's stupid will. Money makes the world go round.
But Daddy, I don't want to do it that way.
Well, why not? It certainly sounds easier. I've talked to those Flat Earth Society people. Enough money and they'll give in faster than a duck will jump on a June bug.
Listen to me. She's at least making more sense than you are.
And besides, with your father's plan, then you can have the business and this Jeffrey person you want so badly. And everyone rides off into the sunset. Case closed.
Yeah, and the business would be so heavily leveraged that any downturn in the market and there's bankruptcy. Not to mention what I want to do for Jeffrey. But I'll compromise. If my way doesn't work, then we'll try yours. Deal?
Fine. What's your idea?
Well, I'm just going to be as obnoxious and clingy as possible until he snaps.
And if he doesn't snap?
Oh, he'll snap. I'm going to be his worst nightmare.
I still think my way is easier.
Well, maybe, but not nearly as much fun.
Girl, as long as you know what you're doing.
Not be this girl, Aunt Bev. She's just gross.
Duncan is not exaggerating, Aunt Bev. I was waiting out in the car and I saw her come out. Skanky is not the word.
The two of you are being a little harsh, aren't you? The girl can't be that bad.
Oh, Aunt Bev, you cannot understand. She's got stringy hair, greasy skin, the most annoying voice in the world. I mean, she talked for almost 2 hours about the end thingies on shoelaces. She didn't even know who Bach or Beethoven was, not to mention Dowland. And she wouldn't even know what a lute was if it walked up and bit her.
Duncan, honey, that's all surface. They make products for stringy hair and greasy skin.
Yeah, but they don't make potions for stupid.
Josh, if you're gonna talk like that, you can just keep your mouth shut.
If only Julia went halfway through the shoelace lecture, I was tempted to kiss her just to shut her up.
Oh, man, I wouldn't do that. That girl was nasty.
Well, kissing her would hardly help now, would it? If she's as homely as you two say she is, she's liable to think you're a prime catch. Maybe the only chance she'll ever get.
Don't say that, please. I don't think I could stand it.
Duncan, why not just say no? You know I'll loan you two the money for that loot shop of yours. I'll be your silent partner. Theory silence.
And what about Joey? If all your money is tied up in our shop, where would you get the money to take care of him? I love you, Aunt Bev, but you're not getting any younger. Joey needs round-the-clock care.
We can't ask that of you, Bev. Joey was my friend. It wouldn't be right.
Look, you two, the skiing accident was not your fault. I'll make it work.
And what if the business fails? What would you do then? No. My way is the only way.
Are you sure you can make this girl dump you?
Oh, yeah. Duncan's been dumped by lots of girls.
Thanks, kid Wad. But yes, I think I can. I just need to be as nasty as I can be so that she won't be able to take it. She dumps me, I get the money, and she gets her family company back.
Threaten to hit her. No woman will stay with a man who hits her. It always works in the movies.
Aunt Bev.
He won't even fart in front of her. He's not going to hit her.
Or threaten to. I'm not that kind of man.
Well, what kind of man are you if you let yourself get married off to some geeky reject just because your short-sighted father's father wants you to? What about this pristine girl you say you want so much?
Yeah, your Aunt Bev's right, Duncan. Your grandfather wants somebody to marry this girl so badly, why didn't he just do it himself?
Whose side are you on?
I'm on yours. Look, I want you to be happy, and if that means being poor with Christine, well, that is what it means.
Josh is right. Duncan, honey, we just want you to be happy.
I will be. I just need to get her to break it off. If I can't, then I'll just leave. But I'm going to be as nasty as I can be.
Just be careful. Women only want the ones who treat them like dirt.
What do you mean that there's a new complication?
There is an addendum that your grandfather added a few weeks ago.
Well, why didn't you tell me this when I was there yesterday?
I'm sorry, Mr. Truman. It just slipped my mind.
Fine. What are the new terms then?
You are aware that you are going to be having a birthday soon.
Yeah, Friday. Why?
How old will you be?
30, so?
The addendum states that you must be engaged within 2 days of your 30th birthday. The wedding must be within 6 months of your 30th birthday.
What?
I'm sorry, Mr. Truman, but those are the terms of the trust fund.
And what if I'm not?
If Miss Denmar refuses your proposal or breaks the engagement, then you get both Denmar Publishing and the trust fund. If you have not proposed or have broken the engagement, then she gets both. There is no middle ground.
So I've got 4 days or I'm screwed?
That is correct, sir. Have a nice day.
Oh, so screwed. Thanks, Granddad. There's a special circle waiting just for you in hell.
Information on shoelaces. What's wrong?
I hate my grandfather.
What did he do now?
They picked this day on purpose.
What are you talking about?
The day I was supposed to meet Mohawk Man with the blue eyebrows.
Yeah.
They picked this day on purpose. You'll never believe this. They changed the terms of the arrangement.
To do what?
We have to be engaged within 2 days of his 30th birthday.
Okay.
And then marry within 6 months. 6 months! My life is falling apart, and this happens.
Wait. When is his birthday?
Friday.
But today is Wednesday.
Exactly. Now do you see why I'm so upset?
Oh, honey, I'm so sorry. What are you going to do about this?
Do? I would put my plan into overdrive. I'm going to get Duncan Truman to dump me.
What about
Jeff? 10 days. I have to do it in 2.
Weren't you dumping out tonight?
Yes. It's Jeff.
Answer it.
Hi, babe. What's up?
Nothing. I just wanted to hear the sound of your voice. Talk to me.
What do you want me to say?
Well, say anything. Tell me that you love me. Tell me what you're thinking. Tell me what you're wearing. Tell me how many kids you want to have. Tell me what you want to name them. Just, I don't know. Just say anything. Anything.
I love you, Jeffrey.
Christine, there's something I have to tell you.
Wait, not yet. Jeffrey, I need to see you first. Nothing gets said till after tonight, okay?
Okay. I love you. Bye.
Bye.
My name is Duncan.
Thank you. gave me a ring, and this is my gift to you.
Christine, you really didn't have to. In fact, if you're having second thoughts...
No, I'm not having second thoughts. Or even third thoughts. And I know I didn't have to. That's the point of the gift. If you have to, then it's bribery. And anyway, if I didn't get you something, I'd be saying I was bought and paid for now, wouldn't I?
Okay. I don't need that in my own words thrown back at me. So what'd you get me?
Open it and find out.
A key?
Yes. And what does every key need?
I don't know. A lock?
Very good, my junior detective. But a key to open what lock? That's the question.
Well, I don't have an apartment here yet to return the favor.
Well, I don't have an apartment here either.
Okay, not a key to your apartment or my apartment. Is it a key to a house or an apartment?
No. I mean, you could sleep there, but if you did, I'd be very upset.
And not a house or an apartment or a place where I slept there without getting in trouble. Come on. Any more hints?
Nope, you have to guess.
It's not a car key, a padlock key, safety deposit box key, I don't know, looks like it could fit into a garage door. Why wouldn't you give me a key that fits into a garage? Maybe a studio? A studio? You rented me a studio?
Well, yeah.
I don't know what to say. I was kind of expecting, a watch or some cufflinks maybe, but...
You don't like the idea of a studio? You don't have somewhere you can put your equipment, your materials. You can start making your loots. I thought you'd like it.
I do. I love the idea. It's just that, well, I don't know where this studio is or how it's laid out or what the ventilation's like or any other stuff that I would have wanted to pick out for myself.
Well, that's the best part. The property management company I got the key from has over 35 studio spaces to choose from. I didn't actually pick one out. I just put down a 6-month deposit on a space that you get to choose. It's a magic key.
Christine, there's something I have to tell you.
No. Nothing gets said between us until this night is over. That's the deal. Tonight, it's just you and me. The rest of the world doesn't exist. It's just you and me.
And a bottle of red wine.
Okay, and a bottle of red wine.
No, but there's something very important I have to tell you.
No, Jeffrey, no. I don't want to hear anything tonight, except that you love me and you want to spend the rest of your life with me. That's all I want to hear tonight.
Oh, I do love you more than anything in this world, and I want to be with you in this lifetime and the next one, but there's something I have to tell you.
No, I don't want to know. 4 days. That's all I'm asking. Just 4 days, and then we'll say everything to each other that we need to say. 4 days. Just 4 days. We can do that, can't we?
Yeah. 4 days. Okay. Everything will be settled in 4 days.
Good. But tonight, it's just you and me.
And a bottle of red wine.
Were already dead, I'd strangle the miserable old bastard myself. 3 days and you lose everything.
Oh, JD, just calm down.
Calm down? You want me to be calm? You want me to be calm, May? My father is turning my daughter into a prostitute just to satisfy some stupid daddy 40-year-old to some guy he barely knew. And now we find out that not only is the man a disgusting slime bucket, but they happen to be engaged in three freaking days, May! And you want me to be calm?
I just have to figure out a way to make things even worse with Duncan. I just don't know how. I mean, he seems to like everything I do. It's almost as if he's playing a game.
I told you not to do this. I told you he'd find you the most attracting thing to come on to him.
JD, that's a great idea. We'll hire someone to come on to him to distract him.
Yeah, I don't think so. He's already hinting that we should get together.
I did not need to hear that.
Sorry, Daddy. He left me a message today asking what size ring I wear and do I like cubic zirconia?
No, he did not.
What is he doing here? What?
Look, it's Josh. It's Catherine's fiance and Jeffrey's best friend.
Good. Maybe we can get him to help us out with this mess you're in.
No, he doesn't know about the mess.
What do you mean he doesn't know?
I mean, I haven't told him, and neither has Catherine. And
what?
He thinks my name is Christine.
Why would he think your name is Christine?
You've been lying to Jeffrey and his friends, haven't you?
It's just about my name and stuff.
Stuff? What kind of stuff? Stuff like that this smelly goat of a man is out buying you a fake diamond ring that he's going to propose you with tonight? That kind of stuff?
Oh, Rest. You've seen us. Daddy, please go along with me here, please.
No, not going to happen.
Oh, Daddy, please. This is my happily ever after we're talking about. Please.
All right, what did you say your name was again?
Christine. Hey, it's great to see you. I didn't know you knew this side of town.
Yeah, my parents stopped in on their way over to Europe, and so we came out for some coffee.
Manners, Christine.
Josh, this is my father, J.D. Denton, and my stepmother, May.
Josh, why don't you join us?
Sure. I have a friend that just got back from Europe, Czech Republic, actually.
Really? What was your friend doing there?
Studying instrument making.
Oh, really? That sounds fascinating, doesn't it, Christine?
Oh, Christine and Jeffrey have already met. Yeah, they hit it off really well.
Really? So, Jeffrey's a craftsman. Excuse me, this is an important call.
So, what kinds of instruments does he make?
Stringed instruments, lutes mainly.
Oh, really? You know, J.D. used to play the cello. He was quite good, too. But his father didn't think it was a profession a real man should pursue, so he had to give it up.
That's terrible. No one should ever give up on a dream. Oh, there's Jeffrey now. He can tell you all about his lutes.
Josh.
Jeff?
Hey.
Christine, what are you doing here?
Well, my parents were in town, so we came out with This is my stepmother, May. Who are you here with?
My Aunt Bradley. It's just my mom's sister. So where's your dad? I'd love to meet him.
Well, he'd love to meet you, too.
Oh, you know, I suddenly remembered that I left my coffee maker on. I'll be right back.
What?
He forgot something.
Beverly Andrews, this is Christine Denton, and her parents, May, and...
J.D. Denmark.
Denmar, darling, this is Beverly Andrews, Christine's young man's aunt.
Pleased to meet
you. Thank you.
So, Christine, I've heard so much about you. Interesting that you took your mother's last name instead of your father's.
Denmar is what the D stands for in J.D. He prefers to go by his middle name. Don't you, Denmar, darling?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Oh, Christine, my nephew's taking quite a shine to you.
Yeah, Jeff is really crazy about her, isn't he, Aunt Bev? And in fact, Jeff is really excited about showing us the new studio that Christine's rented in, isn't he, Aunt Bev?
Well, yes, he is.
Oh, that's Jeff now. Take it over here.
Duncan, where are you? I'm back at your place.
Well, what's the matter with you, Duncan? You ran out of here like you'd seen a ghost.
Her dad was there. That means she was there.
Who's dad?
Dude, Julia, the skank I met yesterday, the one who I have to have dinner with tonight.
He's here? Where? What does he look like?
He was over by the Kramers on his phone. He's one of these stuffed shirts about pain in the ass types.
Well, there's nobody here like that now. You can come back.
No. I can't risk it. Just tell him that I'm not feeling well and that I went to take a nap. Yeah.
Okay, fine. I'll make your excuses for you, but you owe me big time.
All right.
That was done. Jeff, he wasn't feeling well, said he'd just stay home and take a nap. Okay. He has a big job interview tonight.
Really? Doing what?
I'm not sure, to tell you the truth.
It's trade show rep. I believe that's what he said.
That's right. Trade show rep. Working cabinet makers, that sort of thing.
Maybe I should go check on him.
Yes, why don't you go do that?
Where's your apartment?
It's just down the street. Bergman's Landing, apartment 14G.
Okay. Daddy, Thunder, I'll see you back at the hotel at 4. It's so nice to meet you, Beverly. Bye.
Bye, Joe. Christine.
Bye, sweetie.
Is it just me, or do the both of them seem just a little nervous?
Oh, well, you know how new love is, all butterflies and candy kisses.
Yes, but I can't help but think there's more to it.
She's got enough to have herself a little afternoon delight at 11 o'clock in the morning.
J.D., don't be rude.
We can hardly blame them.
Well, Catherine and I are throwing a little surprise birthday and coming home party for Jeff. We'd love it if you all come.
The party sounds like fun. I can't wait to meet this young man.
He certainly does seem like a nice boy.
How are you keeping this a surprise? You told me about it this morning.
Well, he thinks it's a housewarming party. Catherine and I closed on our new house last week.
Oh, what a clever idea. What can we bring?
You don't have to bring anything.
I insist. What would Jeffrey like for his birthday?
Well...
Right.
Check on me.
I know, but Josh said you weren't feeling well, so I wanted to make sure you were all right.
If you're staying around with you, I'm always all right.
Jeffrey, there's something we need to talk about.
I know. I'm sorry about the studio last night. It's just so overwhelming. No one had ever done anything like that for me before. I was just sort of caught off guard. You know, I'm sorry I was such a jerk.
That was it. I didn't want you to think I was trying to control you.
You could never be like that. I think you're the most honest, open person I've ever met. I want to be with you every minute of every day.
You shouldn't say such things, Jeffrey. You hardly know me.
I feel like I've known you all my life, or at least you're the one I've been looking for all my life. I want to bare my soul to you.
Don't. I mean, not yet. But there is something else we need to talk about.
I don't know.
No, you don't. This is really important.
Where are your parents staying?
What?
Where are your parents staying? So that I can ask them if I'm good enough for you. You know, do it the right and proper way.
Jeffrey, I need to tell you something. It's something about me.
Christine, I already know everything I need to know about you. So unless you're going to tell me that you're married, that you're already married to somebody else, then there's nothing else I need to know.
I really need to tell
Christine,
you something.
No. There's nothing in the world that you can tell me that can change the way I feel about you. I love you that much. Everything's going to be so great.
Yes. It's all going to be perfect.
You give your hand to me. Say hello. And I can hardly breathe. My heart is beating so.
Honey, are you sure you don't want a scotch or a whiskey this time?
No, just bourbon on the rocks.
Alright. You know, you look like you've been through the ringer. The wife kick you out?
No, not married. Yeah, yet.
Well, if you want my advice, get out before the big day. Women are just too much trouble.
Oh, you should know, shouldn't you?
Well, I call them like I see them.
Oh,
you want another?
Sure. Hey! Great. So this is my cheerleading squad. Like, what are you doing here? Research. Me and my lovely friend. What's your name?
Oh, you can just call me Rita.
Rita the bartender. You know what? I like that. You can't get drunk now. Why not? Because you have to go out with Julia in 2 hours. All the more reason to get plastered. So.
Nothing. If you're drunk, you're gonna screw things up and blow it.
Julia! Is this the one that's gonna squash you like a little bug? He's been here for over 3 hours, drinking nothing but bourbon on the rocks, complaining about some chick. But he says he's not married. So I figure this Julia chick is the one that's behind all this, am I right?
In a way. Look, can I get a large pot of coffee for him?
I'm sure.
Focus. Gotta get the halfway sober.
Why?
It doesn't freaking matter. I have to marry Julia. Like I'm a freaking retard or something. And listen to shoelace history for the rest of my life.
Now, can you gross her out? She's gonna dump you and life will be fine. I'm gonna be 30 tomorrow. That's when I turn into a pumpkin. Bippity boppity boo and all that Disneyland horror tale ending stuff. I am so screwed.
I know about all the new rules. Keep your eyes on the prize. Get Julia to dump you.
She's not gonna dump me. Have you forgotten what she looks like? She's never had a second date, much less a boyfriend, and now she's got a ready-made husband just right for the plucking. Or something worse.
Duncan, what's the matter?
Oh. Shirt, man. It still smells like her. Oh, Josh, what am I gonna do? I love her so much I can't see straight. Why is this happening to me? For once in my life, I finally meet a smart, sexy, witty woman who would give me the time of day, and I find her, and I can't be with her because I gotta marry someone else tomorrow.
So tell Julia the truth. Maybe she'll feel sorry for you.
Here's your coffee. You want my advice?
Not really.
Oh, that makes me want to give it even more.
What could you say that could possibly make any better.
Well, your friend here wants to be with the one girl, but he can't. So marry the one and keep the other one on the side. People have been doing it for centuries. It's a time-honored tradition.
Not helpful, but thank you anyway. Here, Duncan, drink this. Come on, black coffee, Josh.
Dude, we gotta get you sobered up some so you can face Princess Grace face.
If I have to face her Royal Highness, then you have to promise me something.
What?
You have to be there.
I'm always here for you.
No. At the restaurant.
Why?
Because if I get into trouble and make the signal, you have to ring me and get me out of there. You remember the signal, don't you?
Of course I remember the signal, but I thought the point was to get her to dump you.
It's gotta happen now.
Well, it'll happen.
How?
You're gonna be a disgusting pig.
Yeah, right.
You're gonna fart in front of her.
Farting pig. Well, I guess I can do that.
Good. Now finish your coffee.
You know, if you need some company on this mission of yours, I know someone who's highly available. You know what I mean?
Julia, are you here?
Julia?
Why are you sitting in the dark?
Because I can.
Oh.
I don't need life to get drunk. Hey, I was drinking that.
I know, and you need to stop. Oh,
give me one good reason.
Oh, well, how about your date tonight, huh?
Oh, that's not a reason to stop drinking. That's a reason to start. What is wrong with you? Can't you see my life is in shambles? Can't I just get drunk and forget this whole thing is happening to me?
No, you can't. You have to focus, Julia.
Oh, Catherine. I'm supposed to go have dinner with the most repulsive, barely human being on the planet after I just spent the morning making love with the most amazing man ever created. I'm supposed to be sober when I do it? I can still feel his fingers on my skin. I can still smell him on my shirt. I want him so much I can't stand it. I really don't know what I'm going to do. This is the man I want to father my children. This is the man I want to wake up next to every day for the rest of my life. This one. I've waited my whole life to find someone who sees me for me and not just the hot chick, and now I found him, but I can't have him. I have to give him up.
Tell Duncan, tell him about Jeff.
Oh, good with that, too. He's probably never even had a date before. He's not gonna care that I'm in love with someone else.
Well, give it a try. He can't be a complete beast.
Oh, Catherine, you didn't meet him. He's spit into his hands before he offered it to me to shake.
I know you told me about that, but it's part of the grand plan to get him to dump you, right?
I don't have a grand plan anymore. I don't think I can be disgusting enough.
Oh, yes, you can.
How?
You're going to tell him that you have an STD and that you would kill anyone who would ever cheat on you.
And how's that gonna get Mohawk Man to dump me?
Oh, Julia, all men want sex. It's the only reason most of them get married, in order to get laid on a regular basis. Now, if you remove that option before even going in, he'll dump you.
I don't know. Sounds kind of nasty.
Do you want to be with Mohawk Man for the rest of your life, or Jeffrey? Now's the time you have to choose. Is it gonna be Julia.
Oh, you know I want Jeff.
Well, then you know what you have to do.
Okay. But you have to promise me something. You'll be there. You'll be at the restaurant. And if I give you the signal, you'll ring me and you'll get me out of there.
Sure. Well, now we have to get you sobered up. We can stop breaking my things. And we can send Mohawk Man back out on the warpath after someone else. Come on.
Catherine would never do to deserve a friend you.
All right. Friends are something we deserve. They're something we're given.
Well, I'm going to owe you a lot.
I'm not going to let you forget it either.
You got a friend in me. When the road up ahead is miles and miles, I will die. You're gonna sing as I cast on me.
I just want to hear the sound of your voice. After this morning, I just wanted to make sure that we were good.
Oh, Jeffrey, we are better than good. We are excellent. I just wish I could see you tonight.
I know, but I've got this business thingy, and if I get the job, then I get the exhibition space, plus lots of contacts. You understand, don't you, Christy?
Of course. I just like being nestled in your arms. It makes me feel safe.
I was just going to say the same thing. So what are you doing tonight?
Catherine and I are going to check out a new restaurant, you know, to see if she wants them to cater the wedding.
Which restaurant?
I don't know. Somewhere downtown. Why?
Well, I was just thinking that after my business dinner, that you might want some company. You know, we don't even have to do anything. I just sleep better with you beside me.
That's because you get way too much exercise.
I haven't heard too many objections out of my workout partner.
What could there possibly be to object to? I don't know. We'll probably be out late.
Come on. How long does it take to sample a catering menu?
I don't know. I'll ring you, okay?
Okay. I'll be waiting for your ringtone.
I have my own ringtone. That's so sweet.
Well, you know, I am a nice guy.
Yes, you are. Very nice. In a very naughty way.
I could be the big bad wolf coming to eat up Little Red Riding Hood.
Don't tempt me to break my date. Catherine would never speak to me again, and then Josh would never speak to you again either.
Hey, you know, speaking of Catherine and Josh, they're having a party to celebrate their new place. We could pull some stress off them by showing up together.
Okay. I know she's been stressed over something. When's the party?
Tomorrow. Josh said 7 p.m.
Cool. It's a date.
We can make it 5 and fool around before.
Oh, Jeffrey, really? Anticipation increases desire.
Christine, if my desire increases anymore, I won't be able to walk around in public.
So sad. Tell me what you're wearing.
Right now?
Well, of course. It's almost as good as being there.
Well...
I hate fish.
Okay, no salmon. Chicken? Steak?
I don't care as long as it doesn't have any fish in it.
Oh, well, I'm looking at the menu. They're pretty interesting pasta dishes. Oh, you have got to be kidding.
What?
Nothing. Here I go. Bye.
Wow, she's even worse than last time.
All right. Here we are. My name is Beth, and I'll be your server this evening. Is there anything that I can get you from the bar?
bar?
Sure, Toots, I'll take a triple scotch in the rocks. So, Juju, we are going Dutch in this. You putting out tonight?
I'll have a glass of white wine. Nice girls don't drink hard liquor.
All right, I'll be right back with those.
What do you mean, going Dutch?
Babe, I don't pay for nothing unless I get a little something-something, if you know what I mean.
No. No, I don't.
If I pay for the grub, you owe me later. Or at least, you know, my favorite thing.
No, nice girls don't do that, and I'm a nice girl.
Well, I guess we're going Dutch then. Good. More for me. Unless you want to go hit the sheets right now. Yeah?
I'm going to kill him. I swear, if he so much as touches me, I'm going to kill him. I don't think we should be talking about S-E-X. It's nasty. Besides, I have so much more to tell you about shoelaces.
No can do, babe. Don't care, don't want to know. Besides, I want to talk about us. Now, the way I see it, we fly out to Reno on Saturday, get hitched, and come back on Sunday. Oh, yeah, I even got that ring I told you about. Huh? There it is. Put it on.
Does this count as an official proposal?
Well, that's the rules, right?
You are actually proposing?
What is she doing? Julia is so gross. Oh. Is that a ring?
Oh my god, say no.
No, no, no.
Make the signal.
Here we are. Now, are you all ready to order?
Now that's good. Hit me with another one, sweet cheeks.
Doing that. My name is Beth, by the way.
Right you are, Bethy babe. She's got a fine bar. Look at that. What's the word, Juju? Reno? Saturday? What you got?
Can I get a refill? Please? Come on, people, get out of the way. Is that the signal? Do it again. I guess not.
Word, donkey monkey, let's do it as quickly as possible. That way we can spend the entire flight talking about shoelaces.
Right, whatever you want, sure.
Are you expecting a call?
No, 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 it's just that I thought I felt it vibrate. And that always fires up your own pocket rocket.
Josh, get me out of here. Where are you? Can't you see me making
that? So, where's that hot babe with our food anyway, huh?
I don't think we ordered yet.
Well, shoe lover, let's hurry up and order it so that we can do it in the back of the cab all the way back to your place.
I thought we could go back to your place.
Whoa. No woman comes into my man. Besides, I like clean sheets.
And?
Well, I like to drink a lot, and I don't always like to get up out of bed, and I don't always hit the trash can. Besides, I figured you being a chick and all, you'd have clean sheets. Oh, and you can sleep on the floor.
There you are. Now, are we ready to order?
Yeah. I'll have the T-bone steak, maximum well done, a potato with everything, grilled onions, no veggies, fries, and put cheese on that. I don't know what the broad wants, but she's only got a $10 limit.
I'll have the lobster!
No, no!
With salmon caviar!
I'm not paying for lobster, she's only got a $10 limit.
Sorry, sir, we can't split bills here. I'll be right back with some bread.
Look here, Juju, you're gonna end up costing me a lot of money. When we're hitched, you're gonna be on a shoestring allowance, $5 a week. Eat on that!
What makes you think I'll let you control my money?
Why do you think your granddaddy came up with this great little plan? He knows that broads are too stupid to handle money, much less a radio business.
Oh, fine, you conceited little snot. I've got to have a mind with...
Answer your phone, will you?
Yes? Oh, I don't care anymore. Oh, no, no, you're right. Right. Keep my eyes on the prize. Sure, donkey wonky, my big strong man will handle all the money.
Right.
That means you and my daddy will be spending even more time together. And he knows even more about shoelaces than I do. And you and I will spend all the rest of our time together.
Sure.
We'll never be apart. Wherever you go, there I'll be. I'll be the first thing you see when you wake up in the morning, and
you see when you go to sleep at night. Although, I have to warn you, I don't look this pretty in the mornings. It takes me hours to look this good.
How am I going to get out of this? Ah, snot, come on, you gotta hate that. Sure, babe, whatever you want. As long as I gets mine and a little on the side, it's all good.
No, nice girls don't.
Don't what?
Do that.
Well, you'll be doing plenty of that if you want to stay hitched to me, sister.
I have very sharp teeth.
Well, so what's it gonna be? Are you gonna put that on or what?
I want a romantic proposal or it doesn't count.
Like what?
I want you down on one knee for cleaning your love to the heavens, and I want the crowd to burst into song and violins to play and the whole fairy tale. And if I don't get it right now, I'm gonna throw a hissy fit.
If you think I'm gonna say anything like that, you got another thing coming.
Don't you love me, Doggy Woogie?
You keep your voice down.
Why, Doggy Woogie, don't you love me? Give me this beautiful ring and now you won't even say you love me. Oh, Doggy, how could you?
Here it comes, buddy.
Thank you. Now Christine won't answer her phone. I feel really bad for him. Then there's Duncan's problem.
Duncan? Who's Duncan?
Yeah, I don't think you ever met him. Him, Jeff, and I were all roommates in college. We all worked on the newspaper with Amber. The four of us were the best of friends. Anyway, Duncan had a date with some girl tonight, and he was really nervous, so I just tagged along, you know, for moral support. And the chick was a piece of work.
Four of you? I thought there were only three.
Yeah, why?
Well, Christine and I happened to be at that same restaurant, you know, to see if we wanted them to cater the
wedding. Wait a minute, you were there?
Yes. And we saw you go up to this woman after her date ran out and say something nasty. And Christine just assumed it was Jeff. I mean, imagine that.
Catherine, you've met Jeff. How could you think Duncan was Jeff? They don't look anything alike. For one thing, Duncan's a blonde.
Yes, that's right. He left this behind.
He's going to kill me for telling you this. He was treated for testicular cancer a few months ago. I just finished chemo. All his hair fell out. Christine really thought Jeff was cheating on her? You don't think I have any other friends? But Catherine, I thought you trusted me. Have I ever lied to you?
No, it's not like I've ever lied to you. It just... You're so aggressive with that woman. I guess we jumped to conclusions.
Well, this was probably the only chance Duncan was ever going to have to meet a woman. He's been rejected by eHarmony, Chemistry.com, and PerfectMatch.com.
Josh, I don't know what to say. What should I do?
Just tell Christine to ring Jeff. He's in there right now in the bottom of a rum bottle, and I don't think he's going to be able to climb out by himself. It's going to be one great homecoming party if we can't get the guest of honor to show up because he's hungover. Or still drunk.
I don't know what to say. Should I go talk to him?
No! Just go talk to Christina. She's the only one who put this back together.
Okay, I'll go now. I love you,
dear. Love you too, babe. She's gone. You can come out now. Don't ever make me do that again, you hear me? I'm never gonna lie to you ever again. You hear me?
I hear you. Thanks, Josh. Man. When I saw Catherine at a restaurant, I thought it was so busted. And now Christine won't return any of my calls.
Are you going to have to tell her? You broke off the engagement. That means you're unemployed and poor.
Yeah, I'm the starving artist that Christine fell in love with. Actually, I did get a job today.
Really? Doing what?
Teaching woodshop at Fremont High School.
Hello?
Hi.
Where you been? I've been trying to reach you for hours.
I know. Something came up.
What? Did you think I wasn't on a job interview? Did you think I was out with another woman? What, Christine? What could I have possibly done to have been treated this way?
Jeffrey, just let me explain.
No. Catherine was here. I heard everything. What kind of a man do you think I am? I told you where I was going. Why couldn't you tell me where you were going?
I didn't remember the name of the restaurant.
So you just assumed that some guy was me? Well, did he look like me?
No.
Oh, did he sound like me?
No.
Did he in any way act like me?
No.
Well, then how could you assume that he was me?
Well, Josh was there.
Well, Josh lives here. He has every right to go to whatever restaurant that he wants to.
I know.
Christine, I loved you. I trusted you. I wanted to spend the rest of my life with you. She wouldn't even return my calls.
Why are you using the past tense?
Because I don't know that I can be with someone that I can't trust. Goodbye, Christine.
Jeffrey, wait. No, it's not. Jeffrey? Jeffrey! Oh, Jeffrey, wait! No! Jeffrey!
I really messed up this time, Aunt Bev.
Duncan, honey, what can I say? Are you sure things are over between you and Christine?
Oh, yeah, she'll never speak to me again. Not after what I said to her last night.
Don't be so sure.
Sorry I was such a jerk.
No, I was the jerk. I'm so sorry I didn't believe you. I never meant to hurt you. I brought you a birthday present.
How'd you know it was my birthday?
Catherine told me. I guess Josh told her.
What is it?
It's a keychain that says, World's Greatest Shop Teacher.
You don't mind that I'm just a shop teacher?
I wouldn't care if you were penniless. I love you, not your job.
Thanks. There's something I have to tell you.
No, not yet. 4 days, remember? There's still 2 to go.
Okay. I love you.
You use the present tense.
Forever and always.
Happy birthday.
Yeah, they said he was going to swing by and pick Christina up, be here by 7. It's just now 6:58. They've got 2 minutes.
Well, we can still invite your friend Duncan. You know his number?
I tried to call him. He's too devastated. He's already left town.
Josh, I feel so bad. I'm so sorry.
Forget about it.
Catherine, can't wait to meet my daughter's new beau. You met him, Josh?
Yeah, Jeffrey's my best friend. I'm really looking forward to seeing how you two hit it off.
Yes, that should be interesting.
Well, Christine has been talking about him nonstop. It's like they were made for each other.
Yeah, and with that unpleasant business behind them, they seem to have a bright future.
What unpleasant business?
Just a family entanglement. Christine had to meet someone. Her grandfather
thought
had...
thought she would like. Mm-hmm. And we met him, and it's not going to work out.
When did you meet him?
Oh, I think we had tea around 4 p.m., wasn't it, Denmar, darling?
Yes, 4 p.m. at the Blue China Tea Shop.
Mm-hmm. Really? Did Sharon read your tea leaves for you?
Was her name Sharon, May? I don't recall.
I don't remember either.
Right. Excuse me. Josh, can I see you over here for a moment?
Oh, what's up, Aunt Beth?
I don't know exactly, but Blue China Tea Shop has been closed for the last 6 weeks. Sharon's mother's been in the hospital.
Maybe she reopened yesterday.
Josh, the Ladies Red Hat Society has been having tea at the Blue China Tea Shop every Thursday for the last 6 years. If Sharon had opened yesterday, I would know.
Why would Christine's dad lie?
I don't know, but something isn't right. Why was Catherine asking about Duncan?
Oh, I'll tell you later, but I think it's all going to come out tonight anyway. Oh, there they are. Dude, you are 4 minutes late. Hey, when you're waiting on a woman this fine, you can't rush these things.
Jeffrey, I was waiting on you, and you know it.
Dude, what is he doing here?
What are you talking about?
That's her dad.
I know that.
What's the problem? Is he here to blow? Why would you invite him to this party?
What's the matter with you? I wanted you to meet her dad.
Why? Are you just an evil-hearted, sadistic jerk?
What is your problem, dude?
Party's here.
Great, you made it. Yeah. Three Musketeers ride again. Catherine, Christine, I want you to meet one of my favorite people. Oh, Amber Zimmern's my fiancée, Catherine Edwards.
Okay, so you're the famous Amber Zimmern. I've heard so much about you. This is my friend, Christine. This is Josh's other friend, Amber, the writer for Vanity Fair. She's going to be editing her own magazine in Singapore.
Great, right, it's so nice to meet you. This is my father, J.D., and my stepmother, May.
It's great to meet all of you, but,
where's Duncan?
Duncan. Josh said Duncan couldn't be here.
Well, that's weird. Why would Duncan miss his own homecoming party, huh?
Ah, there he is! Duncan, my big man, how are you? Oh, I must say, middle age is coming up, and you are starting to look like an old man. Did I say something wrong?
Duncan? Your name is Duncan? Really?
Josh, you told me that Jeff and Duncan were 2 separate people. You lied to me.
He made me.
Now hold on. You two are lying too.
What?
That's right. It's before anybody goes climbing up on their moral high horse, remember who's who.
No, no,
You lied to me?
Well, it's not like you didn't lie to me.
So if you're not Christine, then who are you?
Julia Denmark.
The Julia Denmark? The one who I met at Harperstein and Kepler's office? The one who threw a fit in the restaurant last night? The one who now has my money and her family's company? That Julia Denmark?
Yes. And I suppose you are Duncan Truman? The one who stepped on my foot in Harperstein and Kepler? The one who always reeked of onions and garlic? The one who said I had to put out in order for him to pay for dinner? That Duncan Truman?
Well.
I apparently did not get the memo on what I was supposed to say here tonight.
You are not, I don't know you. You are not the woman that I fell in love with. You keep the money. I've got a job. I can't love someone I can't trust. Oh, yeah. You want that back. Good luck getting a refund on the rent.
Jeffrey, wait!
My name is Duncan. Remember?
Josh, Catherine's great party, really. Thank you for the invite. Where's the liquor?
I'll say that I haven't slept in 14 days. I'll say that I can't imagine my life without you in it. I lied, you lied. Everything is even. I mean, how can we love each other if we can't trust each other? I mean, what kind of a future can we have if I have to wonder whether every time you open your mouth if you're telling me the truth or not?
You're any better than I am?
I didn't say that. But what do we really know about each other, Julia, except that you're not who I thought you were and I'm not who you thought I was? So what am I supposed to say to you? No, you broke my heart.
You deserve that. But you broke mine too.
I didn't mean to. But in the end, I couldn't go through with it. I just wasn't willing to sacrifice what we had or what Jeff and Christine had for the sake of money. I'm not saying that I'm good and you're bad. It's just that I thought what we had was true love. And love is supposed to always win, right? I always believed that. I guess I was just stupid.
No, you're not stupid. Just a romantic. You make lutes, an instrument that no one has seriously played in over 300 years. Your whole life is set up to be a fairy tale. That's one of the reasons I fell in love with you.
But you were willing to marry that gross man for money, and I can't get past that.
I know, but I'm not a romantic like you. I'm practical and realistic, and I play to win.
And nice girls don't.
No, but I never told you I was a nice girl. I still love you. I still believe we can be great together. I'm willing to look past everything. It's not just the physical. It is everything about you. It's the way you dream, the way you see the world, the way everything can be worked out if we just believe enough. You're fearless. The world needs more romantics. Anyway, I just came to give you this.
What's this?
Just open it.
I don't want your pity.
I don't pity you, Duncan.
And that's supposed to make it all better.
Just open the envelope.
You know, the last time I did this, we still loved each other. A cashier's check for $3.5 million? What?
It's the amount of your trust fund. I never wanted your money, Duncan. I had to protect what was mine.
Just for the record, I never wanted your family's company either.
I know.
Let me guess. Josh?
You really should listen to him. He's a pretty smart guy.
Yeah. Yeah, he's all right. You know what this means, don't you?
What?
We both got what we wanted. Except each other.
Does it have to stay that way?
What do you mean?
Can't we start over?
Start over?
Yes. With the truth this time. I guess not. You really screwed it up this time, didn't you, Julia? Fairy tales say you only get one shot at true love, and mine just walked out the door. Well, here's to another wasted relationship.
Excuse me. I'm here to meet someone. I'm Duncan Truman. You happen to be Julia Denmark. And I promise I haven't spit in my hand.
Yes, Mr. Truman. I'm Julia Denmark. It's so nice to meet you. You happen to know what the ends of shoelaces are called?
As a matter of fact, I do.
Shut up and kiss me.
I thought nice girls don't.
And what makes you think I'm a nice girl?